All right, so I'm standing at the foot of 21st Street Southwest in Calgary, Alberta. Behind me over here, you can see downtown Calgary, and that river right there is the Bow River. I've got a rented bicycle here to ride with my action camera hooked up to the front here. And in this video, I'm gonna give you a tour of the trails which follow the Bow River heading over in the east direction over there towards downtown Calgary. All right, so we're actually gonna start heading a little bit in the west direction, just so we can go a little bit further upriver to cross one of the bridges up there. And then we'll loop back around and travel on the other side of the river, heading in the east direction towards downtown. So by no means am I a expert in terms of Calgary geography. I'm a tourist here, visiting from Toronto. And I made a video earlier today showing myself riding around downtown Calgary. Oh, my chain just fell off. Give me one second here. All right, we're back in business now. So as I was saying, I made a video earlier today riding around downtown Calgary on some of the streets that have bike lanes. And before making that video, I did go out and explore those bike lanes before starting filming. But in this case, due to time constraints, this is gonna be my first time riding a lot of the trails that we're gonna be seeing. So this video will be more the experience of what it would be like if you came and visited Calgary as a person that doesn't know the geography or the history too well and just kind of experiencing things firsthand. So we're just going across the Bow River now, and we're underneath a big major highway. I'm just gonna look up what the name of that highway is, because I knew the name a minute ago. The highway is the Crowchild Trail Northwest. And now we're back on the Bow River pathway, and we're heading over in the east direction. So Calgary is a really great city in terms of having multi-use trails like this throughout, all around the city, at least from what I understand. And Calgary is a city with many rivers, the Bow River being, I think, the biggest. And it has trails that follow all along it, but so do some of the smaller rivers as well. Calgary is also known for having public art, like the thing that we just went past on our right-hand side. Quite a bit of that downtown, which I took photographs of, which I'll show you here now. So we're just across the river right now from where we started the video. So this trail here is shared between pedestrians and cyclists. Although in the downtown sections of this trail, there are separate paths for the pedestrians and the other trail users, which is kind of nice. We'll get to see those when we get down there. Over on the right, I can see a big train station that's elevated up in the air. Calgary has a transit system which includes electrified rail cars, which they call the C train, C being the letter C, standing for Calgary. So today is Sunday, the 15th of October, 2017. It's a really nice, warm, sunny day for October. I was definitely expecting colder temperatures, at least for during the day, when I came here. In Toronto, where I'm from, we've had quite a heat wave this fall. Some very warm temperatures in September, and even into October it was very warm as well, so it was a little bit of a temperature shock coming here. I guess I want to go over this way. That other pathway probably just leads up to the roadway if I wanted to ride on that road. Go underneath the underpass. The bike that I'm riding right now is one that I rented from the hostel where I'm staying. The hostel I'm staying is called the HI Calgary, or the Hostel International Calgary. It's a chain of hostels. I'm not a hostel expert, so I don't know that much about the history of HI. Calgary does not have a bike share program, like many other North American cities have, or at least they don't have one yet. If they had, it would have made renting a bike a lot easier. Because when I was, you know, looking at Calgary and I was looking at bike rental places, there weren't a whole lot of them that were in the downtown core where I was staying. And a lot of the ones that, you know, even the ones that were in the downtown core, a lot of the bike rental places have closed up shop by, you know, they stopped renting bikes by October. So I was really amazed and surprised when I just saw that the hostel had rentals right there, and, you know, couldn't be more convenient than just, you know, just go to the front desk and rent a bike. So we're now getting more into the downtown core of Calgary. Calgary is the fourth largest city in Canada with a population of about 1.2 million. It's one of two large cities that are in the province of Alberta. The other one's Edmonton, which is the capital city of the province of Alberta. All right, so I guess I want to go down this way. The street, this bridge that we're just seeing here is 4th Avenue Southwest. And this bridge here looks like it's just for the train. So a train just go overhead, but it's also got, looks like a multi-use trail underneath of it. This area is called Eau Claire, that we're passing through now. Eau Claire is spelled E-A-U, Claire. Now I can see that there's signs for a detour route, because right up here, the pathway is closed for a kilometer or a couple kilometers. So if I wanted to get downtown, I should have turned there. But what I'm actually going to do is I'm going to go over this way, and we're going to cross the river and ride on the other side before crossing back. And the bridge we're going to be going over is a good landmark, which is called the Peace Bridge. It's a nice red, bright, modern looking bridge. Just give you a quick shot of it before we ride across it. So that's the Peace Bridge. That was pretty neat looking with all the different web of different things connected together. There's a musician here on the middle of the bridge. I noticed that the bridge has lots of lights all over it, so I imagine it looks really neat here at night too. I haven't been over here after dusk yet. I have no idea how they would have assembled this bridge because it seems to be made out of just giant pieces of steel. Looks like I want to be over here after the bike lane. Looks like just you can't see anywhere where it's been bolted together or anything like that. But I'm pretty sure it's not just, you know, one giant piece that they brought in, because that's a pretty big bridge. It wouldn't be able to fit down a road. So on this side of the river, at least here, there's still a nice pathway, but it is right beside a fairly busy roadway. Roadway looks like it's called Memorial Drive. It's nice to see lots of people out and about enjoying the trails. Another thing I've been noticing is that a lot of the trees have already lost their leaves here in Calgary, and the ones that haven't are all looking very yellow in color. Before I left home in Toronto, we were just starting to see a couple of the trees starting to change color, but the majority of them were still pretty green looking. In Toronto at autumn time, there seems to be a lot more diversity of different colors. Like there's lots of reds and yellows and oranges and some dark purpley kind of colors, which I guess we're known for. I didn't realize that other areas, when the leaves change color, a lot of the trees just changed to be yellow, or just changed to be one color. All right, so we're gonna cross this bridge here and travel back over to the other side of the Bow River. But actually, before finishing our way across the Bow River, we're gonna be on this stretch of landway here, which is an island, which is called Prince's Island Park, which is a nice, very nice looking park close to the downtown. Thank you. When I was walking through here yesterday, there was a couple that had just gotten married that were getting their wedding photos taken here in this park. Over on our right-hand side, there's a big white sign that says Canada 150. 2017 is Canada's 150th birthday. So all around country, there's all kinds of special things for 150th birthday of Canada. All right, so we'll finish our way across to the other side. And now we're in the downtown core of Calgary. If you want to see more of riding around on the actual downtown streets of Calgary, before I filmed this video, I filmed another one where I showed the downtown core, you know, featuring a lot of their bike infrastructure, as well as, you know, just pointing out some other landmarks that you'd see while riding downtown. Seems to be lots of development down here near the waterfront. A lot of construction cranes putting up buildings. Hopefully the bumps on this concrete walkway isn't too bumpy for the viewer at home watching the video. Alright, so we'll do this underpass here. The area that we're going through, or we're just passing by, if we were to turn to our right, we'd be going through Calgary's Chinatown. This is one of those areas where there's separate bike pathway from the pedestrian area. Although that person back there almost walked out into the bike lane by mistake. There was a sign back there saying this is a speed limit of 20 kilometers per hour for bikes. Not exactly sure how fast I'm going, because although I am tracking my speed and my heart rate, the device that I'm using for doing that is actually buried deep into my pocket, so I'm not able to see my speed right now. Here's a people counter. On our right-hand side, there's a display board counting how many people traveling along this stretch of trailway and displaying it for anyone interested in those numbers. Now, the area that we're getting close to now is called the East Village, and that's where the hostel where I'm staying is. It's a low bridge there. I had to duck a little bit to get under it. Another really neat looking bridge over there on the left. This part that I'm riding on right here is completely new to me. I've never ventured over in this direction before. I believe that bridge is going to something on the other side of the river, which is that whole area over there is, or somewhere near that area over there, is the Calgary Zoo. So I'm imagining that's one of the primary reasons for that bridge. I could be wrong though. Over in the distance, you can see the Saddle Dome. I'll just point the camera over there so you can see just barely in the distance. I'm sure it's really hard to see, but it's a very uniquely shaped arena stadium. The roof is sloped down in the middle, and it's supposed to look like a saddle because Calgary's known for the Calgary Stampede and the, you know, it's a cowboy town, I guess you could say. Over on our right-hand side, we're now going past Fort Calgary, which is actually the place where I started my other video where I rode downtown. Fort Calgary is the birthplace of Calgary, first settlement in this area, and from there it just grew. So now we're heading away from the Bow River. Just gonna take a second here to take a look at the map. All right, so as you can see, we were traveling along this trail here. There's Prince's Island, where we crossed back to this side of the Bow River, and we rode along here, you know, as I said, right past Chinatown, and now we're going past the East Village. There's that bridge across to this island, which is called St. Patrick's Island. This Calgary Zoo is actually further over in that direction, but here we are now right near Fort Calgary, and we're actually going to continue a little bit further along this trail here, which is actually a different river. This is the Elbow River, and we'll just continue on until we get to right beside where the Saddle Dome is. All right, so we'll continue on along the pathway, which is now on the Elbow River. We gotta go under this road here, which I think is 9th Avenue Southeast. Another fairly low underpass. So as you can see, the Elbow River is a much smaller, narrower river than the Bow River. And I guess it looks like it flows down into the larger river and they merge together and continue on in the east direction. So straight ahead behind those trees, you can barely see it, is the Saddle Dome, but we're actually gonna cross here to the other side of the river because there's a much better view of it from the other side. And there's a nice park over on this side, which we're just about to ride through. It's called NMAX Park. Also, the sign says Stampede Park. So this again is another one of the venues for the Calgary Stampede. And I saw a sign a moment ago which explained what the Calgary Stampede was, and they said it's the greatest outdoor show on earth. One second here while I put my chain back on. Sorry about that. And apparently, you know, Calgary is a very different place when the Stampede is going on. Tons of people come to the city to participate, and I know all the hotels have different rates for when the Stampede is on. I've noticed that the downtown portion of Calgary seems to be relatively flat, but once you get outside of the downtown core, it's quite hilly. Or at least there are some big hills to get up. If you look on the far left, you'll see that there's quite a steep hill over there in that direction. So I really have enjoyed my time in Calgary. It's been fun seeing a different city, getting a, you know, every city's got its own flavor, everything's a little bit different. So again, there's the Saddle Dome over on our right hand side, but we're just gonna swoop around on this bridge here so you'll get an even better shot of it. So there's the Saddle Dome, looking on it head on. As you can see, it's a very uniquely shaped building. So anyway, that concludes my tour of the river pathways here in downtown Calgary. following the Bow River and the Elbow River. I hope you enjoy joining me on this exploration of these trails. Please leave a comment below and let me know what you thought. And thanks for watching.